Let us understand how to install and set up Spark to try out our practicals. Spark can be installed in two different modes. One is local mode, where only one instance will be running, and another one is distributed mode, where we can have a master and a number of worker. To test out any logic, either of these modes is sufficient enough. To understand the real distribution, how the data works in the distributed environment, we need the distributed mode. We will see both the options. Spark can be installed in any operating system. Let us see how to install in a Linux operating system. We can have a Linux operating system either as a VM within our own Windows machine using VirtualBox, or we can hire a Linux system within any cloud like Amazon Web Services or Microsoft Azure or IBM Bluemix. I'll show a quick example how to start an instance within Amazon, and it's almost the same in any other cloud environment as well. I have registered and I am into AWS account. I'll be getting into the service called EC2 instance, Elastic Compute Cloud, where I can start any number of instances I want. I can launch any instance with any operating system of any capacity. Please do go over the pricing of the Amazon. There are different type of instances, and within on-demand instance, for example, if I'm going for any Linux operating system within Ohio data center or in say Oregon, it would cost around 2.08 cent per hour for a machine of type T3 small. If I want a bigger machine, I can go for, say, if I want 16 GB RAM machine, it would cost around 16.64 cents per hour per machine. I can start multiple machines, and once if I terminate the machines, the pricing will not get charged. I'm going to start an instance. Let me start Amazon Linux. It's based out of Red Hat. Micro instance is eligible for free tier. How much it's eligible, you can verify from the website, documentation of Amazon. Let me start one instance. Let me not change any other value. Let me go with the default value. And let me leave the storage as 8 GB hard disk. If I want to increase, I can very well increase. I'll give a name to it. I'll configure a security group. This is going to determine what all ports to be opened and from which IP address I can access these machines. I'm going to allow only my IP address to access this machine. I'll open other ports as well for my IP address. Do not open all the ports for everyone. You're going to invite trouble. So always make sure you open only your IP address for all the ports. Let me review the details and say launch. Let me create a new key pair. Let me download the key pair. It provides a PEMP file. I can launch the instance. The instance would get created. So within a few minutes, I should be having the instance up and running and I can make use of it. So this is that particular instance getting started. It should be ready within a few minutes. In the meantime, let's prepare the key to log into this particular machine. I am in Windows machine. Windows doesn't understand PEMP file. So we need to convert that into a PPK file, what Windows can understand. For that, we will be using a tool or utility called Puttygen. We can download the Putty. That's a free SSH client to log in to any Linux system from Windows, as well as it provides Puttygen to generate the keys. So you can download from this specific location where you will have the entire package, the Putty as well as Puttygen you can download. So I'm going to open the Puttygen. I'll load the key. This is the PEM file. Let me save the private key. This is going to save in the format of PPK. And I can use it within my Putty tool. The instance that got started will provide me a public IP address. So this is the public IP address. I'm going to use this specific IP address to log into the instance. Let me log into this particular machine. So it's running. I need to provide the public DNS to log into the machine. I'll provide the public DNS. I just give a name so that I don't need to keep giving these details every time. And appearance, it should be a little bigger. And I don't want this to get timed out. So it'll keep sending a keep alive signal every 30 seconds. And the data, I'll provide EC2-user is the default user to log into any Amazon Linux. And I'll provide the key, the private key with which I wanted to log into this particular machine. So I have provided the host name, the user ID, and the key with which I wanted to log in. First time it'll ask me to confirm the fingerprint of this particular machine. So I have a Linux machine up and running, and I have a root access to this machine. I can do whatever I want as long as it is legal.